Hi, this is Sheldon here from the Currency Advisory Desk with today's report. Well, the much-anticipated speech of the Fed Chairman Ben Bernanke gave an unlimited lease of hope to the markets. Now, contrary to popular perception, Mr. Bernanke assured markets that the low interest rates would continue in the United States. In fact, he went to the extent of stating that, you know, even if they go ahead and do the taper, the low interest rate function will continue in the markets there. So that sort of gives the market some sort of assurance that probably there won't be a taper in the coming few months at least. Now, looking at the Eurozone, well, we had the German ZEW economic sentiment, which came in as per expectations yesterday at 54.6. However, the European ZEW economic sentiment came in lower at 60.2 versus an expectation of 63.1. So this set of data was bad for the euro. In fact, we saw the movement in the euro dollar. Once this was released, the euro did weaken a little bit. The Japanese trade balance for the month of October came in lower at a negative 1.07 trillion yen. So as far as the Japanese economy is concerned, well, the policies that the Prime Minister Abe has bought in is working out for them. But if the trade balance does falter for the next coming few sessions also, then we may see some more measures being introduced for the Japanese economy. The yen, in the meanwhile, did weaken further. It moved beyond 100 versus the dollar. Looking at the Indian economy, well, firstly, the first tranche of International Finance Corporation's IFC, Indian rupee bond, was a huge demand as bids were received of around $160 million, which was double the size of bids that were anticipated. So IFC did launch the bonds, and you know, yesterday they wrapped up the bond market sale, and this was the huge sort of demand that has been generated. And in fact, now talks are being held that they would probably go in for another bond issue. They would prepone the bond issue compared to what they had decided earlier. However, the OECD has said, the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, that is, that the Indian economy will grow at a mere 3.4% in the current financial year. So this was sort of a dampener for, you know, the Indian markets. And we saw the Indian rupee also weaken once this news came into the picture. Now, the US dollar index is at 80.62, which is down by around negative 0.11%. Let's look at the technical levels for today. Well, firstly, the dollar rupee futures contract closed at 62.46. We are bullish on this contract and we advise our traders to go ahead and buy the dollar rupee pair. Now, there's support at around 61.77 and the resistance around 63.18. For the euro, there's a support around 83.59 and the resistance around 85.06. For the yen, there is support around 61.91 and a resistance around 63.19. And for the pound, there is a support around 99.55 and a resistance around 101.3. Now, we are bullish on all the four pairs corresponding to the dollar rupee movement, and we advise the traders to go ahead and buy these pairs for intraday trading. Let's wrap up with what's going to happen today. Well, firstly, we have the German PPI, the producer price index figure, which will be released during our market hours. So we could expect some sort of movement in the euro rupee pair as compared to the other sets of data, which will be released later on. Now, we also have the minutes of the Bank of England Monetary Policy Committee, which will be due out later today. Now, even though we know that the Bank of England has maintained its status quo and they're not going in for any sort of drastic change, however, we would watch this report keenly just to figure out what exactly has been the vote out there like. Because what's going to happen is that we want to know who are voting for a change and who is exactly changing their stance and voting against the change. So this is something what we'll keep a keen eye on. And lastly, we have a lot of sets of data from the United States. Firstly, we have the core CPI, followed by the retail sales, the existing home sales data. And lastly, and most importantly, we have the FOMC meeting minutes that will be released post our market hours. Now, all these four sets of data will be released post our market hours. So we can expect some sort of movement tomorrow morning. There will probably be a gap up or gap down movement based on this sets of data. Well, that's it from the Currency Advisory Desk. Thank you.